Alex, I'm here on one of those rare sunny winter days to offer exactly no clarity whatsoever.
What is the fire? What is the fire about? What is going to be on fire?
Instead of answering your question, I want to ask one of my own. Candles? So you asked a lot of questions about certain of my predictions, and in response, I guess, you know how horoscopes and astrology often work by saying things that are really vague, or they're expansive enough to be essentially universal, meaning that, like, yeah, all Virgos relate to this because probably 75% of people relate to this. That's sort of what I was going for with things like Pigeon Renaissance. I loved hearing your predictions though, and I can't believe we had two that were that similar, the One Direction prediction and some kind of North American slash US transit system. I think that per my previous video, you now get to give me some kind of challenge. Maybe even two? I don't know. I didn't really think that we'd have that many similar predictions. But yeah, it really made me super happy that you predicted that I might be a published author. Wow, like to think. And your prediction about the metric system? I also think your predictions about the 2030s and the ways we're going to relate to cars by then were really interesting. But the predictions that I've been thinking the most about this week are your predictions about social media. Like, I think you can't just say that there's going to be a new one and that we're going to totally change our ideas about how we relate to social media without thinking about what the next social media looks like what happens post social media revolution. And I totally get if you want to just like hand wave this away like I did at the beginning of this video, but I think it's a super interesting topic. Since I'm not really on most social media platforms in the intended way, which is not to say that I'm not on some of them way more than I would like to be, just that I'm usually uncomfortable having my own personal account. I don't feel like I have a lot of ideas about how to fix the ways they're intended to work. My initial thoughts, though, about the future of social media is that it maybe needs to be unmonetizable in like every way, like actually actively hostile to advertisers somehow. But like the problem there that capitalism, etc., feed is that then what's the incentive for someone to make it? I think the only ways for this kind of project to be sustainable without profit or monetization are to either A, try whatever it is that Tumblr's doing, although like there are plenty of bad things about Tumblr, or B, have this be a community-driven thing that I think would necessarily be smaller than current social media. And I do wonder if that's something people would be as interested in, given the expectations that we've formed about it based on the current model. Like, important newsworthy things happen on Twitter, and the things your coworkers are talking about are on TikTok. So, do people have enough of an interest in something smaller? Like, it's gonna have less reach, there's gonna be less content, there might be more human contact, but I don't know if that's enough to make it work. The thing about all of that is that I feel like the people who want this kind of model of social media are already using other tools to sort of make this kind of community for themselves and their friends and other community members. Like, I hear a lot about Discord as a way to make these smaller subsets or like group chats of people where you can do some of the same things social media is supposed to be doing, but without being, broadcasting publicly to everyone. The main difference between that, though, and the thing I've been thinking about is that it's all still like dependent and hosted on mainstream social media tools. Like, I know with Google Hangouts, we use that to chat with our friends all the time, but Google is be actively collecting our information. I don't exactly know how this works in other social media platforms because I haven't used them as much, and I don't know how our relationship to our data is going to change in the future. But I do think it's becoming a bigger and bigger concern for people. I guess I worry that I'm just going in a DIY direction that's more like my impressions of the early internet than modern internet. And I'm not sure if I only have this positive view about that because I wasn't really involved in the older kind of internet communities. But I also do sort of feel like there's some kind of backtracking will be necessary in the relationship that we have, broadly speaking, with the way the internet works. Because we need to really internalize the way that social media is bad for us in order to actually work to create alternatives to that. Honestly, though, I think that the fact that this is the direction I've gone in terms of thinking about potentially better alternatives to current social media, says a lot about why I'm not necessarily the typical social media user currently. Like, for a long time, I chalked my reluctance to use social media up to either the stranger danger lessons I got from elementary school or the extremely and excessively bad environment that my particular social media bubble was in middle school. But thinking about social media more recently and talking this through here is making me consider that maybe the kinds of things I've always wanted out of social media haven't really lined up with the options that are available to me. And maybe that's also why I'm still really into Vlogbrothers here on the other side of the mountain, so to speak. I don't know if you feel that way at all, but I'd be curious to know. I'd be really interested to hear more about your thoughts on new social media sometime because I know that you do think a lot about technology and the ways that people interface with it in different ways than me. I was really interested to hear all your predictions about it because I feel like they often go into places I just never would expect at all. But I think that the only way we do manage to actually shift away from a really harmful model of social media is by starting to think about the ways we could replace it more creatively. Even if it seems like more people are starting to recognize now more ways in which social media can be a problem, I think it's really difficult to figure out how to move away from it or outside of it without some ideas of what kinds of alternatives there actually are. So, yeah, I'll see you soon, Alex.